Believers IS Academy. In this video, we'll look at some of the unique species which is relating to the northeastern states. And the mandarin duck here, which you're seeing, is a unique duck which is not of Indian origin, but was found in the Assam Tinsukia's wetland. So this is how a migratory species, and this bird is a very beautiful bird, very beautiful duck in the world. So having such tagline of being so beautiful and meandering in our Assam's wetland could be a very fabulous thing. So that is how I got excited and I was so curious about such duck, and I wanted to share the information about to you people also. So that is why this video is coming up with the mandarin duck, how the places related to that could be also important for us in the UPSC prelims as species in use. So some species which come in use really catch up our interest. So one such is the mandarin duck. What is this mandarin and why this hype is given so much for this? We'll come to know. A rare mandarin duck was observed floating the Maguri Motapung Bill. Bill is a native name for a wetland in Assam region. Regions of Assam we call it as Bill for the wetland. In Assam's Tinsukia district for over a week is spectacular. So as you can imagine, such tremendous colors, the combination of the colors orange, blue, red, that makes it very beautiful. Meandering for a week could be a spectacular view. That is why mandarin duck has made for the news. So for us as an UPSC aspirant, what do you need? You need the IUCN concerns, IUCN status, and what are the founders? Having the beautification, we need the theory also. That is how we look at the mandarin duck as a species now. It is least concerned. It is a least concerned duck. Then considered the most beautiful duck in the world. As I told you, it's the most beautiful duck in the world. And the mandarin duck or the Axe Galericulata. Axe Galericulata was the first identified by Swedish botanist, physician and zoologist Carl Linnaeus in 1758. So have such information, have the fact with you. Carl Linnaeus only discovered the mandarin duck. Then the eBird website. What is the website? The eBird website is a platform that documents the birds world over, describes it as the smallest exotic looking bird native to East Asia. It is very beautiful with majestic colors and can be spotted from a distance. So the majestic colors, the beautiful coloration of that could be spotted from the distance and make it out that it's a mandarin duck. That is how the eBird website calls it a small exotic looking bird native to East Asia. So this was the specifications of mandarin duck. Then what are its habitat and what are its breeding places? We'll have a look here. See, the migratory duck breeds in Russia. Its origin is Russia, Korea, Japan, northeastern parts of China. So you can imagine how we are getting that migration. Now has established populations in Western Europe, the America too. In 2018, when a mandarin duck was spotted in the pond in New York City's Central Park, it created a flutter among local residents. So you can imagine how so much me seeing at the news only could be excited, and seeing at the reality could really make them flutter. Then it was recorded in 1902 in Dibru River in Rangagora area in Tinsukia. So that is we spotted in the 1902 also in the place of Rangagora area in the Tinsukia. This is how you spotted in Assam's first also. But the recent coming was also spotted by the. So basically its origin and breeding partners becomes the Russia, China, Korea, Japan. The East Asian part could be its breeding portions. Then, what is this Manguri Mota? The place where this duck was meandering could be important for us with respect to UPSC. See, the Manguri Motapong wetland is important bird area as declared by BNHS. BNHS is very much important for UPSC prelims as there are questions exhausted on IUCN sites. There might be questions on BNHS also. Which are the birds? Because UPSC nowadays is more concerned about the birds, the rare birds of the birds. That is why in the category of that rare birds, mandarin duck is also chosen for the topic of discussion. Then it is located close to Dibru-Saikova National Park in Upper Assam. See, Dibru-Saikova National Park was dealt exclusively in a separate video of my playlist. So have a look on that Dibru-Saikova National Park, the places in news, the heading dated as places in news. You can have the information on Dibru-Saikova. The horses which are present there becomes the unique part of this national park. The entire ecosystem is very important as it homes to at least 304 bird species, including a number of endemic ones like the black-breasted parrot bill and marsh blackbird. So as you can see, such birds are very much important for the wetland also. That is the Manguri Motapunga wetland. So keep it in mind, such native birds could sometime reflect in the exams. So having an information on that could help you in your prelims. And in May 2020, the bill was adversely affected by the blowout and the fire at an Oil India Limited owned gas well. As you have seen, the Assam's oil, gas, prestige, glass spillouts, how this, even the wetland was also affected. So this is how we saw the complete information about mandarin duck and the places related to that. So I suggest you people to have this connectivity, this connection of current affairs. Whenever a species or a unique event happened, relate to your places, relate the species to the spaces, then IUCN status, sometimes IUCN status and the national park associated with that species. See, mainly these three things could be noted from the species coming in news. So I stress upon and I reiterate every time to my students that have a look on such important points, make notes on them and try to have a brief understanding of how to categorize the current affairs into your UPSC syllabus. This could be categorized as GS3 biodiversity in that species in the environment. So this is how a species under a short note could be done. I guess we have reached a conclusion of our video, and for such categorization, for such interesting videos, you can subscribe onto our YouTube channel Believers IAS Academy, and you can log on to our website www.believersis.com, and you can also call upon our number 9611005946 for any inquiry relating to the UPSC examination, the foundational courses, the optional preparation or the interview guidance. Anything could be inquired by using all such medium. And you can follow us on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter for any further infographics, the nice content, the daily current affairs in our website also. So that is how you can make the best use of believersis.com for accomplishing your UPSC dream. So that's it for today, and thank you.